Hi friends, let's study ISP 98 rule number 1. This is video number 7 in regards to rule number 1. We are studying electronic presentations now. For earlier rules, you can watch the other videos of up to video number 6 for rule number 1 only. And others, they are in other videos as such. So let's start. Electronic presentations. The following terms in the standby providing for or permitting electronic presentation shall have the following meanings, unless the context otherwise requires. Electronic record means, now this will always confuse you, electronic record. Now what does the line above means? The meanings given over here will have the same meaning given over here, unless the credit or the body of the document states something different, then that will prevail, not these ones. So electronic records, there are two definitions. One is in ISP 98 and also one is in EUCP. You'll always get confused between the two. So let's start for ISP. In EUCP, I have covered it in separate video. For ISP, we are covering this. Electronic record means a record. Information that is inscribed in a tangible medium means hard disk or DVD, or that is stored in an electronic or other medium. Electronic medium means you can consider it cloud, and it is retrievable in the perceivable form, means which can be retrieved in a perceivable form, means it can be a physical copy or you can also view it online. Both these things should be possible. That is called as perceivable form. Second, communicated by electronic means to a system for retrieving, storing, retransmitting or otherwise processing information. Communicated by electronic means, it means it must be sent by electronic means, either email or something, anything it can be. So, and it receiving, storing, retransmitting or otherwise processing information, we must be able to do all these functions, only then it can be called as a record, otherwise it's not a record. So data, text, images, sounds, codes, computer programs, etc., software, databases and the like. And the third one is, it should be capable of being authenticated and then examined for compliance with the terms and conditions of the standby. Means we must be able to retrieve it and authenticate it. Authenticate means we must be able to know the sender also, who has sent it, and then examine for the compliance with the terms and means the terms and conditions of the standby. This document must stand by it, must abide by it. Only then it will be called as a electronic record. Let's check the similar definition of electronic record in EUCP. Electronic record as per EUCP means data created, generated, sent, communicated, received or stored by electronic means. Similar meanings here, the wordings might be different in ISP and EUCP. But if you see the logic, that is similar to that. Created, sent, transmitted, communicated, received. Similarly, that is being capable of being authenticated. Same wordings are there in ISP also. As per the apparent identity of the sender, means identity of the sender should be known. Apparent source of the electronic data contained in it, means we must be able to know the source, that is in EUCP. As only this part, apparent source of the data content, this is not there in ISP 98. And whether it has remained complete or unaltered, this is more comprehensive. So this is not included in ISP and is capable of being examined for compliance with, this is common. So this second part in EUCP and second part in ISP, they are different. See, ISP also says about authentication, means we must be able to authenticate it. Only ISP doesn't speak about is this line, apparent source of data contained in it, and as to whether it has remained complete, means in exams you will be asked, as per ISP 98 the electronic record means, or as per EUCP electronic record means. So the difference is only this line, remaining everything is same in ISP as well as EUCP. ISP does not have this line and EUCP has it. That is the main difference. So that was it regarding electronic record of ISP 98. So you can download this YogaGuru app from Play Store to get these videos, question banks with explanations directly from on your mobile. You can also get a physical copy of the question banks with explanations from this site. It also contains in basket as well as simulation exercises. You can get the DVDs of all these videos from